Hello friends, welcome to City Kids. What do we do in City Kids on Sundays? We learn about Jesus. Yes, we have so many Bible lessons to learn from. But before our Bible lesson, we are going to sing a song. Do you remember our song? The one that says, J-E-S-U-S, you are the best. You do? All right. Let's sing it together and make sure you jump as high as you can. Did you jump as high as you could? Yes, I trust you did. Now, today's class, Auntie Victoria has a very, very fun game for you. Make sure you listen and I'll be back to ask you one very simple question.
So welcome friends, and yes, I have a game for you. It's a little bit tricky, but I think you can get it. All right, so can you see the objects on the screen? There is a book, there is a pencil, there is a cup, and there is a shoe. Can you see them? Okay, so this is where it gets tricky. Now, I'm going to show you the shadow of one of the objects here. And you have to guess which picture the shadow is representing. All right, so let's start. Look at this shadow. Look at it carefully. Which picture do you think this shadow is representing? Look for it here. Look for it here. The book. Well done. Good. Let's go to the second one. All right, look at it. What picture is this shadow representing? Yes, the cup, come on. Well done. The third one. Look at it again, look at the shadow, look at it. And look for the picture. Which picture is this shadow representing? The shoe, well done. And the last one, look at it. What picture is this shadow representing? The pencil, well done, good job. Thanks for playing that game with me. And, well, I could see what the object looks like much better when I look at the object itself rather than the shadow. Did you feel that way? And exactly, this is how we can understand what God is like. Now, in the Old Testament, the prophets, the priests, and the kings, they were like shadows of God. They showed us just a little bit of what God is like. But in our Bible story today, we'll be learning that Jesus is the greater prophet, the greater priest, and the greater king. Jesus is God's son, and he showed us what God is like clearly more than anyone else. In fact, Jesus is the perfect image of God. Let's watch our Bible story to find out more.
Hello everyone, Megan here, and this is Jesse.
Hi.
Jesse, want to play a game with me? It's called What's Better. You just have to say what's better between two things.
Sure, I can do that.
Okay, what's better, chocolate or vanilla?
Oh, I say chocolate.
Okay, what's better, a swing set or monkey bars?
Ooh, that's a tough one. Monkey bars.
Okay, good. What's better, singing or dancing?
Dancing.
Okay, last one. What's better, Jesus or everything else?
I know this one for sure. Jesus.
Yes. Today's Bible story is about how Jesus is better than anyone or anything. Listen to the story. Following Jesus was difficult for many of the first Jewish believers. Some of them began to wonder if following Jesus was worth it. It might be easier to stop worshiping Jesus. The Holy Spirit helped a leader write words to encourage the early church. We can read these words in the book of Hebrews. The leader wrote, "Long ago, God spoke to his people through prophets. Now he speaks to us through Jesus." Jesus is God the Son, and he is like God in every way. Jesus sits right beside God in heaven. Jesus left heaven to become a man. Jesus became a human being like us so that he could die and then rise again to rescue people from sin. Jesus became like us in every way so he could become a merciful and faithful priest for us. Because Jesus suffered and was tempted, he can help us when we are tempted. This is why Jesus is the greatest. He is even greater than Moses. God used Moses to bring the law to his people, but God used Jesus to bring the gospel. This is why we cannot turn away from Jesus. Instead, we must encourage one another every day. We do not want to be like the Israelites who rebelled against God after Moses led them out of Egypt. Because Jesus is such a great high priest for us, we can keep following him. Jesus knows we are weak because he became a human and was tempted, but he never sinned. Because of Jesus, we can boldly go to God, and God will give us mercy and grace. This is why Jesus is better than anything, and why we cannot turn away from him. Salvation is found only in Jesus.
So welcome back. As we go through the lesson, we have three questions we have to answer. 1, 2, and 3. So whenever you hear this sound, it means it is question time. All right, let's move on. Our Bible story is from a book in the Bible, the book of Hebrews. Can you say Hebrews after me? One more time, Hebrews. Is it already time for our first question? Let's find out what is it. What it is. Today's Bible story is from which book in the Bible? Did you say Hebrews? Oh, well done. Come and give yourself a round of applause. Woo, well done. Thank you for paying attention. Now, what is the big idea we are learning from the book of Hebrews? If you're ready for the big idea, can you say big idea? A big idea from the book of Hebrews is Jesus is better than anyone and anything. Can you repeat that after me? Jesus is better than anyone or anything. Now, Auntie Funke is going to ask you after I'm through, so please don't forget. Yes, Jesus is better. Jesus is better than anyone or anything. He is the better prophet. He is the better priest. And he is the better king. In the Old Testament, that reminds me of something I wanted to tell you about the Bible. The Bible is divided into two. The Old Testament and the New Testament. Can you repeat that after me? The Old Testament and the New Testament. So, it's time for our second question. Let's find out what it is. The Bible is divided into two parts. Can you name them? The Old Testament and two. The New Testament. Come and give yourself another round of applause. Woo! Thank you for paying attention. Now, the Old Testament were some of the things that happened before Jesus came. And the New Testament were some of the things that happened when Jesus came and even after he went, he ascended to heaven. Now, in the Old Testament, there was a king. Kings wear crown, right? Okay, so let me wear this crown. There was a king. He was so powerful and he was really wise and he was really rich. He lived in a very big and beautiful palace. His name, can you guess the name of the king? King Solomon. He was so rich and so powerful and he was the king of Israel. He led God's people and he was the first person that built the first temple in Jerusalem. The temple was really big and beautiful. Look at the picture. Yes, Solomon led God's people, but he didn't lead God's people perfectly. King Solomon sinned against God. And with how powerful and how rich and how wise King Solomon was, King Solomon died and he's not alive today. Do you know why Jesus is the better king? Jesus is the better king because he leads people perfectly into God's kingdom. And Jesus never sinned. And even though Jesus died, guess what? He rose again and he is still alive today. So this crown reminds me that Jesus is the greater king. Okay, look at this microphone. Do you like it? Can you hear me? This microphone reminds me of prophets in the Old Testament. Prophets were the people who spoke God's word to others. There is Prophet Isaiah, there is Prophet Jonah, there is Prophet Malachi. But these prophets were imperfect. For instance, Prophet Jonah, God sent Prophet Jonah to Nineveh to speak God's word to them. But he didn't want those people to be saved. And so he ran away. These people were imperfect. But Jesus is the greater prophet. Why? Because Jesus speaks God's word to us perfectly. All right, let's keep going. Now, before Jesus came in the Old Testament, it was the priest's duty to always sacrifice animals for the sins of the people. But because the sacrifice of these animals was not able to pay for their sins once and for all, they had to keep sacrificing over and over and over and over again. And even the priests themselves, they too sinned and they had to sacrifice for themselves. But Jesus is the greater priest because Jesus paid the sacrifice for sin once and for all. Jesus came down from heaven, he became like us. He was tempted, but he never sinned. And he went to the cross to die, to pay the perfect sacrifice for our sin. So this cross reminds me that Jesus is the greater priest. Everyone who believes in Jesus receives salvation from sin through his perfect life, his death, and his resurrection. And because Jesus is such a great high priest, we can keep following him. Okay. So this crown reminds us that Jesus is the greater king. Well done. This microphone reminds us that Jesus is the greater prophet because he speaks God's word perfectly. And this cross reminds me that Jesus is the greater priest because he paid the perfect sacrifice for our sin. So let us... Oh, I almost forgot our last question. It's time. This one is 3. Are you ready? Who is the better prophet? Jesus, well done. who is the greater king? Jesus. Well done. And who is the better priest? Jesus. Come and give yourself another round of applause. Well done. Thanks for paying attention. Jesus is better than anyone and anything. Let us pray together. Dear God, we are really, really thankful because you sent Jesus. Thank you, God, because we can know what you're like when we look at Jesus. Lord, we thank you, Father, because Jesus is the greater King, because he leads us perfectly. We thank you because Jesus is the greater prophet, because he speaks your word perfectly. And we thank you because Jesus is the perfect priest, because he paid the perfect sacrifice for our sin. Thank you so much. Lord, help us to believe that Jesus is better than anyone and anything. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Now over to Auntie Funke.
Okay, so did you have your listening ears on when Auntie Victoria was telling you today's story? You did? All right, there's only one way for me to find out, and that is by asking you the question. Is Jesus better than your mommy? You're thinking about it. Is it better than your daddy? Is it better than your favorite toy? Well, like Auntie Victoria taught you today, Jesus is better than anything and anyone. Can we say it together? Jesus is better than anything and anyone. Okay, remember that. All right, it's time for our memory verse. Do you remember where our memory verse is from? 1 Chronicles chapter 16 verse 31. And today we are going to learn it with a song. But let me remind you what it is. It says that, let the heavens be glad, let the earth rejoice, and let them say among the nations, the Lord reigns. Let's sing this song together. Have a great week. Bye.